Today we'll be speaking about undines, the nature spirits of the water element. In just a few minutes, I'll share a couple of more tips how you can build a relationship with the elementals. As with the sylphs in my previous video, the name Undine comes from the works of Paracelsus, a 16th century alchemist who wrote a book about the elementals of fire, air, water and earth. The Latin root of the word undine is unda, which means wave. Undines are beautiful mermaid-like beings that live in the sea, lakes, waterfalls, rivers, ponds and everywhere where there's water. Like all other elementals, the Undines can change their form rapidly. Neptune and Lavara are the hierarchs of the Undines and the water element on planet Earth. They have explained that the seas have a special significance in relationship to humanity. The Undines control all fish and mineral life in the seas and waters in the Earth. They control the oxygenation in the waters and also the tides. They maintain the plants in the seas. They have much control over the climate as well. They cleanse the waters from poisons like industrial waste, chemicals, pesticides, sewage and oil spills. Given that about 71% of the Earth's surface consists of water, you can imagine that this makes their work extremely important for our ecosystem. They purify our waters every day. They do this by constantly recharging the electromagnetic field of Earth's waters with the currents of the Holy Spirit. Water is a very important element on Earth. Nothing can grow without water, and humans cannot survive more than 3 days without it. Therefore, it is very important to let them know how grateful you are for their work. Let's take a look at an example of what it looks like to work with elementals. I've taken this from the book How to Work with Nature Spirits by Elizabeth Clare Prophet, which includes this witness by one of her students. My son and I were on the way to my mother's house in a small farming town in the Midwest. With us were my nephew and my two nieces. They decided that they wanted to have a big rainstorm so that they could play in it. Their mother was very protective and strict and didn't allow such things. But they knew that their grandma and I would think it was harmless fun. The children asked me, if we pray to the elementals, will they make it rain? I explained about God's laws and that the farmers were cutting hay and needed it dry. We couldn't ruin the hay crop just so we could play in the rain. So they worked on the right prayer and asked the sylphs and undines, over and over in God's name and according to his will, to just make it rain in town so as not to interfere with the crops. And could it please be a real thunderstorm? They asked. With lots of water? Just as we came close to town, out of a clear blue sky, clouds came up and poured down rain in a 6-block square. It rushed into the streets in front of the house like a river. The children were ecstatic. The thunder was horrific and the deep water a bit frightening. My nephew said, with eyes wide, Aunt Ellen, do you think we overdid it? They had a jolly time rolling in the muddy water and were very satisfied with their experiment. The freak storm was on the news and in all the papers, but the hay cutting was not affected at all. What an amazing story! We all can have faith like these children and start working with the elementals right away. Alright, in the other two videos of this video series, I already explained some of the problems elementals need our help with. One more issue they have to deal with is the following. Some elementals are imprisoned in animal bodies. This is something that was never intended by God. Many, many thousands of years ago, scientists on Lemuria and Atlantis, which were two continents that have since perished and disappeared from the history books, were very evolved. The people started playing around with God's creation and found a way to imprison elementals. In particular, the scientists of Atlantis wanted to limit the elementals' expression of the Holy Spirit and manipulate them so they could use them for their own purposes. They used advanced methods of magnetism and mind control to put a kind of transparent cage around elementals that looked like an animal form. These cages were not tangible at first. They were actually electronic force fields, but with time they actually manifested in matter. Which means that the elementals were literally imprisoned in an animal body. Millions of elementals became prisoners. This doesn't mean that all animals are imprisoned elementals. Many animals are parts of a group soul and evolve within the animal group. They are not like humans who have an individual soul. Now imagine elementals having been embodied in an animal body, for example a dog, cat or horse, for thousands of years. They have forgotten where they came from and what they really are. Their new identity is being an animal. You may know a dog or a cat or maybe some other animal that is very talented and devoted to the family it lives with. In many cases, these intelligent pets even replace family members and become very dear to their owners. It is quite possible that that dog or that cat you are thinking of is an imprisoned elemental. That's why they need our help to be set free and once again become what they were intended to be, an elemental. One more tip that is recommended in the book Working with the Masters by Mark L. Prophet and Elizabeth Clare Prophet, in order to work with the elementals and build a relationship with them is a bit surprising. In a dictation in 1983, the Ascended Master Gautama Buddha asked to hang beautiful nature pictures in our homes to inspire elementals to recreate the same scenes in our world. He said they would meditate upon these images and outpicture peace and purification. Just imagine the kind of positive impact these elementals that are peaceful and full of light can have. Something else that is recommended in the book I just mentioned is to pray to Elohim Cyclopea. The Elohim carry the highest vibration of light that we as humans can comprehend. Elohim Cyclopea is the Elohim of vision, and his cosmic consciousness ensouls the vision of God as the creator. You can ask this great cosmic being to send his divine vision to the elementals, who then can keep the blueprint of the perfect state of planet Earth in their inner being. This can help them materialize what they know to be true within. I know that you care about the elementals as much as I do. Let's all help them with the violet flame and by making the following call for them to God daily. In the name of the I am that I am, I call forth the intense action of the violet transmuting flame around every salamander, sylph, undine, and gnome. Saturate the four elements, fire, air, water, and earth, with the violet flame this day. I accept this done right here and now with full power in accordance with the holy will of God. I imagine the undines every day dancing in violet flame. I imagine being in the ocean, swimming with them, collecting whatever garbage we can find in the ocean. Plastic bags, pieces of metal, discarded rags, and tossing them into a giant violet fire where they just vanish. I imagine them tending the water plants and having beautiful gardens with flowers of all colors. I imagine them purifying the water wherever there have been oil spill accidents and helping animals whenever they are hurt. Of course, these are just my own visualizations, but they might inspire you to create your own. Visualize whatever expresses your love for the elementals and add the violet flame to it. Don't forget, the elementals depend on our help. I'll add the mentioned book links in the description below this video. Links included in this video might be affiliate links. If you purchase a product or service with the links that I provide, I may receive a small commission. This helps me to continue providing you with free content. I'd love to hear your feedback. Have you seen an undine or sensed their presence when you were out by the water? Do you have an experience with them that you'd like to share? Leave me a comment below this video. Please give me a thumbs up if you like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for your interest and have a great violet flame day.